I'd say that Sir Stanley has, you know, suffered at the hands of history since 1974, perhaps unfairly, whereas João Havelange, the Brazilian, was seen as a great internationalist and Stanley was seen very much as a parochial European. But that's not really fair, is it?
Let's be fair about it. It was a trick, really, of capturing the votes. And Brazilian FA were going around the African countries, and there were 36 African countries, and they all had votes, and they were paying for two representatives to go to FIFA conference, all expenses paid, if they would give the vote to Avalanche. This was corruption, bribery, really, but what could you do about it? And this move, let's be fair about it, I mean, to some extent, the South Americans felt that they were cock of the hoop, you know, winning football and so on, that they should be in the power place. And it's time for a change anyway, to swing the power out of Europe into South America, which is what happened. There were all so many factors moving that way. It didn't take much to push it into place. And the secretary of FIFA coming up, the young secretary who was going to take over, was also in cahoots with Havelange to get Havelange in the job. There always is this kind of thing. So it was a new regime taking over, virtually. New secretary to FIFA, new chairman, and South Africa at long last in a place of power. South America, sorry, in long last in a place of power.